Welcome guys, it's time to play. We don't have too much time today because I'm going to the movies later, but this might not be a problem because the daily quest for today is Hunter, and the arena run is also Hunter, or Hunter's available. That's good for like two reasons, because the first one is I haven't played Hunter since GVG's out, so this might be just a disastrous short run anyways. The second is that Hunter games are usually a little bit quicker than other games, so I hope we can do this. And let's just hop right into it. And I guess it's injured Blightmaster, one of these two, three. This is actually very interesting. I don't have a clue what I should pick. Unleash is kind of a situational card, which is sometimes just really, really good. Tinker Town Technician, well, I don't know with how many mechs I will end up. And the Leper Gnome, I don't know. It's probably, if I drafted an aggressive deck, it would probably be good, but I don't know for now. I think I just go Tinker Town. Should be the most solid option here. Out of these two, three, these are also three good cards. I like the Fairy Dragon as a two drop, but I think I go Piloted Treader just because it has so much value, or the potential of so much value, I should say. Raid Leader would have worked with Unleash, but that's nothing too. I could pick the Snipe and hope for a Mad Scientist or something, but multi-shot is at least one removal should be really good here. Dex Skill Healer is the best out of these three. Mountain Giant won't work. Echoing Ooze is okay-ish. Steamwheel Sniper is actually pretty interesting. Has good stats, and you get like twice as good. You get the hero power that is twice as good as the mage hero power is. I think I will try this. Haven't played with it yet, but it seems very interesting. Let's say Raider might work because of cards like... I'm more likely to pick up a weapon because there's Glaivezooooka now. Fen Creeper could also work very well. I don't have two so far, like also just the Steamwheel Sniper. Let's say Raider has a potential upside, but Fen Creeper is just a good catch-up card. I think I go Fen Creeper right now. There's the weapon, so I should probably have taken the Blood Sail Raider. Would have made Snipe, for example, also better. I think Bow beats the Mind Control tag. Not by far, though. Earthen or Unleash or Tracking. Oh, my 3 slot becomes better and better, it seems like. Yeah, it's one of these. I would pick the Tracking over some mediocre cards, but... I think I want the potential of having good cards. I think Farseer is good because I have some high health minions so far, and also works with Blightmaster, works with Fang Creeper, so it might get me a 2-for-1 and the body's reasonable. Probably not. Also, I have a lot of 3s. Glaivezooooka. Oh, I should definitely have picked the Bloodsail Raider then. I don't have any beast synergy so far, so probably... That's probably not the reason why I should pick the Bloodfen Raptor. It might be because of my 2-drop lag, but Glaivezooooka should make up for it. Let's see. I have a taunt here. I kind of want to pick the Shieldmaster also, but I'm... one-third through the draft. I want to have at least 6, so I'm kind of below average right now, so let's go with a 2. I think second Darkscale Healer beats second multi-shot. I'd also pick the Owl because it is silence and a beast, but... Multi-shot is also great removal, but it's also kind of situational. Seems like I have to pick up some high health cards. Deadly Shot might be better than Kill Command right now. Don't have any beasts, and this as removal should be better. Thundra Rhino, well, I don't have any beasts. Met bomber or ooze? Probably bomber. Yep. Might get overrun early, so I might also be up against a lot of weapons. Maybe ooze would be better because its potential upside is better than the met bomber upside, but should work too. Definitely ogre. Especially because I have so much healing, high health minions are really, really powerful then. Mani Berserker. I mean, I have two weapons for the deck hand, but Mani Berserker is just really good. And works really well with Glaivezooooka too. Out of these, now it's getting interesting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stonewind Champion is pretty good card. I didn't pick both Unleashed though. But then the 4 slot, I only have the Piloted Shredder now, which is kind of disastrous. So I think the truck could actually work very well. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 2-drops so far, which is kind of the amount of what I would like to have. None of the minions are very efficient though, so 1, 2, 3, 3-drops without max, sadly. 1, 2, Stomach Chamber is probably too good to pass up though. Especially with cards like Dark Scale Healer, which can actually do even more work then, but not having 4-drops is also kind of disastrous. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, go champion. I'm not sure if this is correct though. Gives my other mags. I don't have any other mag, right? It's a 3, 3, 4, 3 though. Oh, well, I have this mag. I have a lot of 3s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This kind of counts as a 3-drop. This doesn't, so. I think I go with the Nullifier just to have, like, I have max synergy a little bit, and this probably isn't too annoying. Would have liked to have a Shieldmaster instead, but looking at my curve, I definitely need a 4-drop. Especially because I passed up the last one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2-drops. Well, really fits the curve here. I'm not sure if I want to pick Lutorta or Webspinner, though. Don't have any beast synergy still, so getting a random beast might be good, might be bad. Drawing a card is always good, I think. Although I can play this on one. If I pick it up for a turn one, it's a little bit better than Lutorta. I might be forced to pick a kill command later, so we would have, like, that's like two beasts for a kill command. Also for, I don't know, Houndmaster or something. Especially because I need more force. Still think Lutorta is better. Webspinner into Glaivezooooka could have some upsides, but let's just go Lutorta. That's interesting now. It's really interesting. Nefjaggler or Azure Drake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 5 plus cards. This draws me a card though. I don't have any card draw besides the Loot Hoarder, I think. No. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2 drops. I think I go Azure Drake. Should be better overall. Tall Strider because of my lack of 4 drops. Oh my goodness. Hunter's Mark is removal. Another good 4. Misdirection is probably not good enough. There's the Houndmaster, and I don't know if... Well, I have the Tall Strider. Probably a second Glaivezooooka. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Ravenhold Assassin could fit the curve. Also gives me more reach. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... I still have 4 3-drops though, but... Second Injured Blademaster isn't gonna cut it, I think. Third Glaivezooooka, really? Probably not, right? Snapjaw is a beast. Well, I don't have any beast synergy. I passed up the Houndmaster, so... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... Well, Glaivezooooka could work. Third one, though? Well, I have some healing, so... I can heal myself back up. It's probably better. 1, 2, 3, 4 4-drops now. That's a little bit... Okay. Fine. Mad scientist or a freezing trap. Scientists, do I pick up, like, how many secrets are going, how many picks? That's 26 cards, so that's the 27th, I have the 28th. I have like two chances of getting a freezing trap, like getting a secret for the mad scientist. Huh. Freezing trap can be good, but... Maybe Clockwork Gnome. Clockwork Gnome is just a solid body. No, it's not, but it's a 1-drop. I don't have any 1-drop so far. And it gives a spare part, which sometimes is useful. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Well, I could make this work somehow. And maybe we can pick up a secret. It's kind of unlikely, but... Also works with a Glaivezooooka, so okay, fine. Panther. Unleash or Berserker? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Berserker might work. I think Unleash is a little bit better, though. I don't have too many catch-up cards. The weapons kind of work, but they... okay, Unleash, I think. And a second bow. Oh, that's a lot of weapons, then. I have four already. Huh. Five weapons is probably too much. Jeeves, unimpressive body. Summoner? Well, with this curve, I think I want to be on the coin more often. But the 2-drops become better, especially 2-2s become better with Glaivezooooka, at least a little bit. Because they can trade better then. But, Okay, let's go pint size. This deck didn't work out as I would have liked it to be. Well, but I have at least some removal and at least some catch-up cards, so overall might work out somehow. Three Glaivezookas might be too... I haven't played them yet, so I don't really know. The Mad Scientist is just a 2-2. Steamwheel Sniper might actually be really good for catch-up things. Also, if they can't be removed, like played on turn 2 and can't be removed immediately, I might be able to just shoot down one of my... opponent's minions. Pilot Shredder, Violet Teacher. First slot is okay now. I don't really like the Arcane Nullifier. We'll see if this pulls some weight. Dark Scale Healer 2, Fend Creeper 1. I'm kinda... Well, I have three heavy hitters in the late game. It's a little bit concerned, but like a Venture Co. or something would have helped, but... We'll see how this works out. I'm still not too confident, but it seems like I never am, so... there we go. So it might actually work, I don't know. We'll see. Delishas becomes worse against the Paladin, I guess. The Scientist is a keeper. Do I keep the injured Blademaster? Question is, are there any 3-drops that I would like to see otherwise? I think I just have 3/3s and weapon. Maybe a jungle panther, but yeah, well, I'll keep this. 2 and a 3 is pretty good. Ooh, I got the earthen ring combo. So I can coin this out and then play this, and then play these 2 and 4? I don't know. Probably not. I'll probably end up playing... What do I play? What's the worst thing that can happen? If you play something with 3 HP, then Mad Scientist is probably better? No, I can trade and keep this alive with Glaivezooooka. Okay. Probably can't remove it right now. If he plays something with 2, I can just shoot it down. Well, if he plays something with... If he plays a 3-2, I will shoot it down. If he plays something with as a 2-2, I can just hit it. Especially because... No, I can hit it here. Well, it doesn't really matter right now. Okay. Glaivezooooka it is. I think I don't want to hit him. I have two more of these, but I might need to use them later. If he plays an ooze, it's fine. I can still kill it. I think Earthen is pretty good here. I might play into a Consecration, but well. He just kills the Steam Weedle then. My eyes are open. In my sights. Would have been interesting to play Injured into Earthen, but that's way too greedy. I have to kill this, and this way I can keep this alive and keep my hero power alive. Reporting for duty. So if I play the Nullifier, then I hit this here. If he has a true silver, he can kill it. Well met. Greetings, traveler. I don't want to play the bomber, and I don't want to trade here because of consecration. I could trade and then this is still alive, but this is not a big body if he plays a 5. So I think I hit this with a weapon, hit him twice and play the Nullifier. Yep. Magic detected. Like, the only card that can... is really annoying now is... No, there are a lot of cards, actually. Blessing of Might, for example. Blessing of Might, Argent Protector. Blessing of Kings. But they can all be handled somehow. So I would like to play with my hero power now, I guess. Could use hero power, injured. If I had one of my Darkscale healers, it would be really sick. I can hit this with my weapon, actually. He plays, he can hit, and... Okay. If he consecrates... I don't know, that's not a truck. If I want to spend 5 mana, I use Blademaster Amani, I guess? Yeah, this looks fine. Also plays a little bit around Consecration and can target minions. Doesn't have to. Yeah, plays pretty much around Consecration. Only quality... Oh my goodness. Off the top. Don't consecrate me now. This would be insane. Not on. Ah, okay. Reporting for duty. Bomber is kind of risky right now, right? 6, 10, 12, 14. Well, I can kill him one turn if he doesn't heal, right? Is this enough, though? Might be. What's the alternative? Alternative is I shoot this, hit this, this hits this. It's. Doesn't look that great.
I wonder.
He didn't have a consecration, he would have used it. So. Avenging Wrath could be a problem for this board, obviously. But then he can't heal. If he plays Guardian of Kings, he goes up 6, he can trade 3 minions away. Oh, this should be fine overall.
Pay attention, class.
Who you want me?
Yep, didn't know. No. Oops. Where does this come from? Even if you consecrate, yeah. No, he has to heal. Or to kill me. Doesn't look like he can.
Reporting for duty.
Didn't have to use this, but was fun. Oh, you could play Voodoo Doctor.
Jane.
A mage.
You asked for it.
Let the hunt begin.
2, 3, 4 going first is probably as good as it's gonna get. And I'm likely to pick up more twos on the fly anyways.
Hello.
Greetings, traveler. What you want?
That's okay.
Mind if I roll me?
I'll probably keep the earthen for some utility around. Well, he might, yeah, he probably pings this. If I play Panther now, I can't get through this grunt. So I guess I play earthen.
My eyes are open.
It's kind of sad, but. If he hits pings, it's okay. If he plays a 3, I have the tall strength. Oh, this might not work out, but I don't really have a choice here. If he has one spell, like a Frostbolt, he can simply kill my board and still has a 3-1 around, and can play something for 2. He can also just kill and ping it. Still has a 2-drop. Or this, okay. Interesting choice. I guess I can simply play the Fen Creeper to protect it. Is there any other way? Azure Drake dies to this ping. It's a little bit too sad. On the other hand, I don't have much that survives a Flamestrike, so maybe I should keep the Fin Creeper around. On the other hand, if one of these die, then I might not be able to deal with whatever he plays anyways. Next question is, do I want to hit it? Maybe wanted this and has two spells in his hand. It's totally possible. So if he pings my Tall Strider, he has 3 mana, which should be fine with the Ashen Dragon. I'll go the safe way. And I have a fast card to react. I can play this and this, and maybe Fen Creeper for the turn 7.
Put this apple on your head.
Oh. So I can keep both out of ping range. His next turn is 6 mana. And then I play the Fen Creeper. 2/4 attack minions. It's probably the best way of doing it. Might just play the Raven Alt Assassin actually.
Tazdingo!
Hmm. 5 health is pretty nasty right now. Oh no, never mind. This and Fen Creeper and double hit. This dies anyways. This has 1 or 2 HP dependent on what the Glaivezooooka hits. No, if the Glaivezooooka hits this, I can simply hit. Okay. Saves this, it's a 5/2 frozen for the next turn, but I can keep it around. It's probably better. Yep.
I hunt alone.
I can also protect it if he has an abusive sergeant or something for this. Or Dark Irondorf. Don't know. I can't remember what I picked over the owl.
Ready, sir.
If he would have had a flame strike, he probably would have pinged this, right? Huh. That's interesting. Yeah, I knew that the Dark Scale Healer could pull something. If he had a if he had a Flamestrike, he'd probably pink this, I guess.
I wonder.
Well, it doesn't really matter, because even if I heal both of them up, it doesn't really do anything. If I play Dark Scale Healer, what can I play with it? Panther? No, everything dies but the Ravenhold Assassin. So, it doesn't really matter. If I hit this, it's a 3-2, 3-4. Hit. Then he Flamestrikes hits. It's not great. That's the problem with this stack. It's very reactive. Also just play Ravenhold hit. No, he probably wants to ping it. I think he doesn't have a flame strike. I think. Well, let's just play this. It's not good. It's not that good anyways. And I can play these two next turn. If he doesn't have Flamestrike, I'll probably just flood the board. That's a lot of stuff. Ah, Unleash would be good. So that's 7, 9, 11. Could put him to 15. 15 is not really doing anything. He trades here as a 3-1, a 4-1. Then he trades here. Here, ping as a 4-1. I can't get rid of these 1 health minions then. So what am I gonna do? I could hit here. Hit
my
here.
Magic will tear you apart.
Well, could try Hunter's Mark Mad Bomber. Hit this before. Not really going to cut it. I think I'm just doing it this way. Is there a reason to use the Hunter's Mark? No. I think it's good. Because he didn't have the Flame Strike, and this way I can get a 1 for 1. Not really a 1 for 1. You know what I mean. Where's the sniper guy? Oh boy. None of my minions survive Flamestrike, it's still the same story.
Wanna blow something up?
Yay. Didn't really do anything. 11, 14, 12. It's there anyways. Oh yeah, it's there there. Oh. I go full in here. It's not much I can do anyways. Yeah, now you can hit it ping. 6, 8. 11, 13. Huh. Okay, he doesn't do it. That's 10, 14, 16. Huh. Looks kinda strange to me. He might have 2 fireballs or something. Just wanted to close it out. I mean, I could hit Darkscale Healer. Don't have a way to enrage this, sadly. Ten, 12, 14, 16. I could put him down to 4. Then I go up to 19, take 6. 13, double fireball would kill me.
I wonder.
Problem solved.
Who you want me killed?
So if he finds this Flamestrike, one of my minions will survive at least. And nothing is in ping range. That's 11, 15, 17, okay. Oops, forgot to update the score the last time, I think. Oh no, oops. This was the second game. Thought it was the third one. The next mage.
Let the hunt begin.
This deck isn't really I don't expect it to be good against mages. If just a few minions that survive flame strikes. Injured Blade Master, do I want to keep it going first? I have a lot of early games, so it might be reasonable. He has kept two cards and has coin. Which probably means that my Injured Blade Master is going to die anyways. After it hit the board. Do you want to see something rather than the Injured Blade Master as three? Probably not. Maybe Jungle Panther, but probably not. Can keep it. Yay, Glaivezooooka without a minion. Oh, there's my minion, but no secret, sadly. Ugh. So the hope is that he doesn't coin. Okay. He has the coin, so he has a guaranteed spell. Otherwise, Glaivezooooka would be really good to trade here, but he's most likely to trade. Make this a 2-3 and trade. There we go. Well, I guess I just continue to play in curve then. Problem is, he can. There are a lot of options for him next turn. Can hit ping and keep his Worgen alive. And after that, I play Tallstrider and he pings it and hits me for another 4 and then hits the Tallstrider. I could just play Glaivezooooka and kill it, but then I take 8. And he plays a minion with us, so. Oh boy. At least he didn't hit it twice. Wow. That's a rushy way of doing it. I could unleash and clear. Unleash Hunter's Mark clear. Could hit here. Play Tallstrider, dies to the board. And it may take another 3. Might be the best thing to clear. Keep the 4-2 alive. Can make it 5 attack next turn, which is good against this 4 drop. Should be good enough. A little bit excessive with the Hunter's Mark there, but. I think it's my best bet right now. Yeah, 5 attack isn't going to be enough for this one. Dexcavia is probably the best bet here. It's to hit, ping, it's a 2, I play Glaivezooooka, I have a 5-5, can play a 3. Seems good. I might take 3 and be frozen. Okay, at least it took his whole turn. But now I take 3. Be frozen. Glaivezooooka. Huh. So there is a line of play. Glaivezooooka hit, Glaivezooooka hit. Armani Berserker. Oh boy. That's so inefficient. Problem is, I think there is no other way of doing it right now. I could play Tallstrider, Berserker. Kills the Berserker. Or maybe hits me again. Pretty much behind already. Oh, no, I can't even hit something. Well, whatever. T- two mana, deal one damage, miss four. Ugh. Well, if he has a... No. Really? More efficient trades incoming, yay. So if I play the Tolstra, you can just run it into... get one of my guys. And I have another Glaivezooooka, yay. That's what I needed. I can't even trade both away. Yeah, whatever. Let's see how far we can rush him.
I've got a huge
gun. Okay, so he'll get my Tall Strider. Which means that the next Glaivezooooka is... isn't going to do anything to... I probably have to hit this. I see myself dead already, but hey. This just dies for free to this. I can hit it again. Take another 9.
I wonder.
Yeah. Pretty grim. So overall I have a total of 5, 4, 6, 10 damage over 2 turns. I play this, he hits this, hits me.
I wonder.
I don't think that there's a way. Like if I hit this, play this, play the Glaivezooooka, then this is a 3-5. He hits this. Plays whatever he can with 5 things, and then I just die because I don't have any more cards. Ugh. I think that's my best bet right now, even though it's a pretty... But I take the 4 damage anyways. I might take 8 though, but I don't know. I probably lose anyways. I'm not even sure what I need right now.
Wanna blow something up? Wanna blow something up?
9, 11, yeah. Right.
Well fought.
That's the problem with drawing 3 Glaivezookas at once, being up against a mage and having a low minion quality overall. Yep. And drawing into a low curve, I mean, well. No, the Duckskin Healer was there. Fen Creeper, Argent Commander would have done something. Oh, I haven't seen my Pilot of Shadow so far. That's good. Guess I can keep it, it's my best 4. I also have the coin for some flexibility, should be okay. 1, 2, 4, 5. Oh. I have to find something for in between. Please play a 1 health minion.
The light protects.
Okay, this kind of works. Go, Bomber! Wow, didn't hit me. That's a surprise. Thought he would roll 1-1. Glad he didn't. Glaivezooooka or Sniper? Probably want to improve my board. If I trade here, it dies to Earthshock. If he had an Earthshock, would he have played it? Probably. So it dies to all the 3 damage summon spells anyways. Yeah.
Target acquired.
Sweet. It's probably better, hopefully. Why didn't he use it before in the bomber? Oh, and abusive sergeant top deck. Well, that's unfortunate. Glaivezooooka would hit something, but that's probably okay. The scientist just dies and doesn't even leave a secret behind. Pallet Shredder. Okay. Yeah, no, there wasn't really another play. Oh, I have the injured Blademaster Earthen Ring combo. Probably next turn? Oh, maybe next turn. Maybe not. For now, I think it's Fencreeper. Deals well with this and survives. Let's see what 2-drop we get. River Croc seems okay. Can deal here. Oh. And I might just play the healer next turn. If he doesn't clear my board. Still 2-for-1. Well, depends. Not really. And a bow. Bow seems good. So bow could kill this next turn. I think I do. Well, injured. Injured would mean that he will probably trade here instead of letting it grow. And if he doesn't, I can play Dark Skill Healer or something. I'll find a target for the whole healing stuff. Face. Well, that's greedy. Especially with my weapon out. I think he wants to burst me down, right? Okay, so hit, seems very obvious. I go down to 11. Does he have a hand to burst me down by 11? Like, double crackle with this one or something? Seems a little bit weird. I can kill all of them for free, basically, with the healer. He didn't kill the croc, so he might not have one damage. Don't have any minions that require positioning. Yeah, well, if he kills this, it's okay-ish. If he doesn't, I have the earthen. Earthshock. There we go. Probably have to trade into this now.
Hey, give me that.
These two. These two Ravenhold.
Hey, give me that.
Well, I have the card advantage, just have to use it. Oh, that's even better.
I'll show
Just put more stuff on the board. It's probably more important than anything else right now. Get rid of his totems and get rid of his board. Okay. It's not too scary overall. Although I can't deal with all these three health guys. But he didn't have a hand to burst me down. That's for sure. So, Stonewind Champion would be best top deck right now. Yep.
Greetings, traveler.
So I'll definitely kill the totem with one of these. And... Scale healer, nice. So much healing. Could also. No. Well, yeah, I probably should kill this one twice. This one. I don't really care about these two, actually. I don't really know what I want to heal right now, so I probably just don't. Next turn he plays something earthen, totem. Makes me four guys, four attacks against his guys. If he draws flame... okay, should be fine. Maybe I want to heal myself, maybe something really bad happens.
Tazdingo!
That's good. So I want to heal the ogre. Hit. Earthen. Assassin? Yeah. Well, assassin is a problem against mind control check though. What is he thinking about after doing, probably just stalling. Do you play it now? 10, 12, 14. I probably just play what I draw instead of using the Ravenhold. This one, for example. Do you use multi-shot for two totems? 10, 14, 16, 20. Huh, could set up lethal. I'll just do it this way. Whatever he plays, he will play a totem with it, so the multi-shot can target anything. Oh, there's the crackle. He'll have to top deck 10 damage next turn. Whatever.
I wonder.
A few turns ago, the chat was arguing about what cards he could hold to kill me. Alakir Rockbiter, Coin Maligos Lightning Bolt Crackle. And then he played all the small cards and they were combined stats of 4-12. Nice.